Hello, everybody, and welcome to Atlanta Motor Speedway. This is NASCAR.com GarageCam. I'm your host, Matthew Dillner, bringing you live inside the NASCAR garage. Oh, what a beautiful day. Blue skies. You see these tires piled up right here. Getting ready for the Rinnai Tankless Water Heaters 250. There's one car not in the garage right now, and that's number 41, Kevin Harvick. Stewart Haas Racing entry for this 250-lap showdown tomorrow. And oh, what a beautiful day at Atlanta. Welcome to NASCAR.com GarageCam in the Xfinity Series, where we have a lot of fun. So this is a fun show. Let's get it kicked off by telling you this. There's no chat room, okay? Here's the deal. No chat room. Hop on Twitter, man. Everybody does it. All these drivers. Kevin Harvick's on Twitter. He's probably tweeting right now. Hop on there. Use the hashtag GarageCam. One word. Hashtag GarageCam. A bunch of people are starting to do it already. Let's interact. Let's all become even more of a part of a community, a bigger community with Twitter, and have some fun. All right, here we go. Into the Xfinity Series garage we go. And yeah, what? Yeah, I do want that. Can I have CJ, our all-star audio guy? I think we lost Eagle, our producer. See, we're a behind-the-scenes show, so we show you stuff like this, and we also show you stuff like this. I mean, it's CJ, it's Eagle, the producer, who's monitoring our GarageCam hashtag on Twitter right now. Eric Amarola, the number 98. It's windy.
I think you need to use this on your microphone that you wear.
This what?
You need to use this.
I need a bigger one of those fuzzy
windscreen.
Things.
It's a windscreen.
It's a fuzzy thing. Let's just call it a fuzzy thing. The people will know it as a squirrel. It's the Daniel Boone. Anyway, I digress. Austin Dillon, the number 2. Jeff Green. This is a former BJ McLeod car for Jeff Green. As the wind blows, it is a BJ McLeod entry for the former series champion. Well, Jeff Green, check this out, okay. Jeff Green, he's not by the car right now, but Jeff Green has 14 starts in the Cup Series and now has 14 starts in the Xfinity Series here at Atlanta. He also has 2 Truck Series starts and 1 ARCA start. You want to talk about stacking it up, man. That's incredible. You can hear the wind behind me. We're sweeping here. We're sweeping, we're mopping, we're sweeping. Morgan Shepherd working on the side skirts of the number 89 entry with the gold wheels this year, celebrating 50 years in racing. Tell us who you are on that chat. You wanna know where you're from? I always like that. Well, not on the chat, on the hashtag GarageCam. Luis DiDonato, I would like to see Elliott Sadler, please. Yeah, we will get right up to, when we get up to Elliott Sadler, Eagle will remind me, and we will show you that car, of course. Luis D, man, you're like the pole position king. I think maybe you ended the chat room. Maybe that's what it was. You got the pole position too many times, they ended it. Cole Custer, the 00. A lot of talented people working on this car, from Eddie DeHunt Jr., over there. So many people hired over, some Gibbs guys hired over as well onto this 00 for Cole Custer. The Harmonator. Got some good cars in the backside of this garage, but right now you see this hoist. That's because they're going to be changing the power plant. They'll be changing the power plant on that number 74 here shortly. In between, this is your tweener, man. GarageCam tweener. In between two practices, they just got off track for a practice. Now getting back on track. For another one. It's nice and loud here as Hendrick Motorsports engine guy gets going on this Michael Lynette, number 5 from Junior Motorsports. Michael Lynette with a decent run at Daytona. hoping for some big things. Here's a double duty dipper right here, the Young Guns, number 24, Corey LaJoy. We talked to him on GarageCam over on the Sprint Cup Series side. Motoring our way through here. We'll see if our producer sees any drivers up ahead. I see the Chris Cockrum car, the number 25. Spencer Gallagher, the Allegiant Airlines number 23. Just such a beautiful day in this garage area here. You see, it's hard to see, the sun's right up there, but it's glowing down so gloriously on this garage area here at Atlanta. David Starr, the Texas driver. Hey, I think I see D Star over here. David Starr over here with crew chief Jason Miller going over some things. All right, D Star and Miller, what you guys up to?
Man, we're just we're struggling a little bit on the racetrack. Our striping technology, Chevrolet, is really tight down there in the middle of one and two. We get down in the corner, right until you get to the center of the corner. The front end just feels like it has no grip, you know, just actually almost like the tire is, it's kind of how to describe it to the fans. It's like it's hitting ice and the front tires just skate to the right. And we really hadn't been able to run a clean lap yet. And my crew chief, Kenny Evans, we're just kind of our teammates, crew chief Ray Black Jr., Jason White's crew chief, we're over here just talking, just trying to figure out. It's really a mystery. We changed everything with the paint job and can't seem to get it through turns one and two. So we're struggling a little bit, but making more changes. Thank God we got another practice. So, yeah, hopefully we can figure it out, because it's been pretty ugly.
It's no fun when you got a car around this thing handling it like a beast.
It's a challenge even when you got a good one, you know what I mean? And when this thing won't act right, it's a big challenge. But hey, that's what it's all about, trying to figure it out, and that's what we're doing. Just haven't been able to lay down a clean lap yet. Just like I said, we get down at the bottom of one, turns one and two, and the thing just takes off to the right, to the wall. And man, you can't race like that. So it's killing our momentum time-wise, but we're working on it. Like I said, we've changed everything, and we'll see what happens. But I love it. We'll just keep digging.
All right, David Starr, we appreciate it. Good to see you as well, my friend, the number 99. Striping technologies on the side of that car. Well, check it out. Here's one of the feel-good stories of the week, and that is Joey Gase. Great run at Daytona, man. It's got to give you a little extra oomph in your step.
It definitely does. It does me and for the whole crew, and it gets her ear out on the right foot, and it helps a lot. It really does.
People don't realize the work that goes on these cars it, away from the racetrack, here at the track, and there's such a respect level from a lot of us, but maybe not mainstream, for your guy, your car owner there, Jimmy Means.
Yeah, I mean, we're a very small team. We only have like pushing six full-time guys. That's including here at the racetrack. And when we're gone, there's no one at the shop really working. We got two guys, so it's really tough for us. As far as budget goes, we don't even have a quarter, not even a quarter of what the top guys have for the whole year. So it's really tough for us. And the top seven is, I don't want to say it's a win, but it feels really good.
All right, man. Great run last week at Daytona for Joey Gase. A nice top 10 finish there for that underdog team. Of course, Jimmy Means, longtime competitor in the sport, in the cup ranks and short tracks, and somebody that I personally got a lot of respect for, and still busting his butt over here in the garage every weekend. It's weird, actually, because I don't see him, and I usually every time you look at that 52 car, he's got his hands on it. Brandon Brown, the number 90, Sunfrog shirts. I was just talking to Brendan a few minutes ago, and he was like, man, I got to get on GarageCam, get that Sunfrog shirt, sponsor some love, and I don't know where he went. But hey, let's show you something cool. Come here, guys. Hey, this is what a driver should do. Look at this. He's working. He's working it. New job, Harrison. Man, you'll do anything, wouldn't you? Sweeten the floors and all.
Try to help out.
try to help out around the garage when they're taking it through tech.
Yeah. So now you just got to do your part, the second part of this practice. What do you think you got after that first practice that you learned?
Yeah, we had the same set of tires on for both times.
Oh, you did? Okay.
Yeah, so, you know, we're not going to go bust a lap unless we put stickers on. But I think we're going to throw right sides on it and kind of see what that does.
Okay.
Maybe a race strategy there, so we'll see how that goes. But just working on the handling a little bit, I think we'll be okay. We always race better than we practice, so we'll be all right.
Build on that Daytona momentum?
That's it. Awesome to start the way with the top 10. I've never started the season that good, so to be that high up of points and to have that momentum going forward is pretty awesome.
All right, Harrison Rhodes right here for John Lee Davis Racing. Teammates to the number nothing right here of Garrett Smithley, who, he's had a lot of fun too, Garrett Smithley, this year so far. But last week was a challenge, going through the graphs and spinning out at Daytona. Ray Black Jr. with the Scuba Life. Scuba Steve is what we like to, right there, that's Scuba Steve. We're just gonna call it Scuba Steve. I mean, I think Harrison Rhodes is doing a good job. I gotta say, I'll give him an A+ for effort, sweeping things up here on GarageCam. Man, not a lot of people out. I guess there's a lot of debriefing going on in that garage area, but hey, make sure you tune in every week on NASCAR.com. We have GarageCam, usually on Fridays. Typically, it's before the first practice session. Today's schedule really had us doing this one in a between practices, so we're going to just call it our little tweener. It's kind of fun. It's kind of different because, well, we got a lot of time here to kill, and we've got only half the garage to go, so this should be a lot of fun. The other Johnny Davis entry, the number 4 from Ross Chastain, the Florida native. And you see the helmet, as always, the watermelon lid for Ross Chastain. I actually was driving through Cordele, Georgia yesterday in Watermelon Capital Speedway. And the Chastains have a bunch of watermelons, watermelon farms. Tigra, Leesburg, North Carolina. I love Jeremy Clements, BG, and Kevin, of course. Well, here's one of your favorites right now. The number 51 of South Carolina's Jeremy Clements. Good to see this number 51 as we back out here to show you this new paint scheme. Last week, we saw the red car, the brand new car for the Super Speedway, and now we've got this Rinnai tankless water heaters sponsorship on board the number 51. Great to see. I mean, this is a team that has a father as a crew chief, only a few guys working on this car, and man, they get a lot out of a little great underdog effort here, and awesome to see a sponsor supporting such a competitive, fiery young man with a hard-working group.
Race sponsor too.
And it is the race sponsor too. You gotta love it. You gotta love it. Hey, you know, Ryan Sieg is over here. How about we go see Ryan Sieg? All right, hanging out at the back of the hall, or kind of old school here. I don't know. He's got his head down in his hands. Uh-oh. What's the matter?
We weren't very good. That's what's matter.
To be frank, so you're looking for speed, of course. Did you find any speed? What is that, dumplings?
That's right.
What you have there? Chicken and dumplings will help you find speed.
That's right. Hopefully. I wish.
So Georgia native, coming here to Atlanta, obviously growing up and all the cup racing, man, in the history here at Atlanta, it's always got to be special to roll in, kind of a hometown deal.
Yeah, it is special to come to Atlanta. Always want to run good here and try to get the best finish we can here at Atlanta, especially in front of friends and family. But it's fun to come to Atlanta, your home. Hopefully we can get it. We should be able. We're close. We're getting there, but just unloaded, not where we wanted.
What's the most Atlanta thing you could think of? Would it be the Braves, the Dukes
of course,
Hazzard?
The Braves. That's it right there, Atlanta
the
Braves.
Braves. Yeah. You a Braves
sure.
fan?
Yeah.
Sweet.
Yeah.
So are you a Falcons fan?
We're not going there.
Wait, what? I we found this sign somewhere. We were just kind of wondering.
We're not going there.
What happened?
I don't even want to talk about
it. So you're going to be much better, though, in your car on Saturday than the second half of that Super
Bowl. Oh, for sure. Yeah, they blew it bad. Oh, it was awful. It's awful.
All right, we're going to let you decompress after that interview. Man, we just found that sign. It was something else that we found that sign in the garage. And it was ironic because Eagle here is a Panthers fan. I don't know what happened, but we found this sign. I just saw it at the beginning of the show. It was on the stack of tires, and somebody's posting these things all over the garage. I really don't know who. Must be a Panthers or a Patriot fan or something. Jeremy Clements, what's up, man? You got a new sponsor?
Give me that.
What, we're gonna wrestle, Mike? We're gonna wrestle.
Let me have the microphone.
No, I want it. I want it. No, you got it.
Oh, you want me to have it?
I don't really want you to have it, but no, you can have it. Yeah, you can have it. So repairablevehicles.com, man, they've done so much for you. But I'm really excited to see this new sponsor here, Renai, on your car.
Yeah, don't trip, by the way, because we don't have insurance in this garage right here.
But so. You realize that I'm like the stealthiest fat guy you've ever seen in your life,
man. If you fall and break your leg here, you're done.
Yeah, I'm done. Here, see, watch. Look at the backward skills.
That's right.
I still got you on here. I'll even iris up when we go into the dark here. Look at this.
I don't have a clue what you just said, Well, how about this? We got the Renai tankless water heater Chevy over here. She's looking good. And I'm going to tell you what. You can stay in that shower all day with these water heaters like
this. You got one of those?
I'm going to get one.
You need to get one.
I'm going to see if I can get a deal on one. Maybe they'll cut me a little break. But I have been in houses that have had them. And I was like, man, I want one of those for my house.
So you just basically wanted to stay at that person's house the whole
time.
Yeah,
exactly. I didn't worry about, hurrying in the shower. But I just really appreciate them coming on board, and hopefully we can get them a good run. They deserve it. And is your camera broke?
No, I got you.
Okay. He's over here messing with it. I don't know what he's doing. Does he know what he's doing?
No, absolutely not. But, hey, man, Daytona last week.
Sucked.
Yeah. I mean, you rolled in there with optimism. You had a brand-new car, but had to really baby it during practices.
Well, because we only had one car.
Exactly.
In the trailer.
And then?
We had one bullet in the chamber.
And then what happened to that bullet?
That bullet got destroyed. I mean, I don't know what these guys were thinking behind me. I was dodging a wreck on the backstretch. Like, we just took the green flag after restart, dodging a wreck, and just got killed from behind, sent straight in the wall, and that was it. I mean, it killed that thing. So, I don't know what's going on here.
Did you see there's signs, like, everywhere in the garage? Have you seen any of them?
No.
Oh, wait, there's a sign on your car?
Man, I'm going to tell you what.
Who's putting those things up? Do you have any idea?
I didn't. It was him over there, but he left. But
are you a fan of the Falcons? No, right?
I like the Falcons. I got a lot of people here that love the Falcons.
Interview over.
Yeah. You're a Patriots guy, right?
No, dear Lord. My brother is, but that's because he was dropped in his head as a child.
You're from New England, right?
No, I'm from New York. Big difference. Long Island.
Okay.
Originally, but.
Well, they should have won the game. I mean, I think I could have called the rest of the game when they got up 28-3. I would have just ran the ball, kick a field goal, been done with it. Like, let's go. But instead, they're like, here you go. Take it. I play a lot of Madden. So, hey, man, I can call. if the
football
Atlanta,
coach, football coach,
if
and
the
race
Falcons
car driver.
Need an offensive coordinator, hire me.
Done deal. Jeremy Clements, the Renai.
Guys, it's been fun. I'll see y'all later.
Hey, man, we always love having you on the show. We appreciate it.
Hey, tell Tigger.
Wait, here we go.
I forgot. I'm sorry. I was looking at Twitter just a minute ago. Tell Tigra I said hello. Hope she's having a great Friday.
So you were following along the hashtag GarageCam.
Oh, yes.
Cam.
That's what I'm so sorry. I think
she's having an okay day.
Nothing like – yeah, she is. She's a big fan.
Read that tweet.
Nothing like watching GarageCam having a snack and adult beverage.
I'm so jealous. Son, I wish I could be
I might try to go get me one of those now. I'll get in turn one deeper.
Yeah, you can skip the second practice.
I'll be more brave then.
Well, we talked about the Atlanta Braves, but Jeremy Clements. I love that kid. He's good. He's good. He's a good kid. Hey, where's our microphone? Oh, did we get it back? That's good. That's good because I think I see Blake Cook over here. And there is the Georgia Natives car, the Ryan Sieg new paint scheme. And here is the leaf filter gutter protection car. And what was that coming in there? Having a little fun on GarageCam, but you guys were maybe not having as much fun in that practice, really searching for speed. You guys think you got it down?
No, not yet.
Not yet.
We were searching for speed first practice, second practice, but we've been making a lot of changes. and hopefully it'll come to us here in this final practice when it counts. But you know, you know my team. It's like the best team in here, man. They're gonna keep fighting. Their heads are down. They're not giving up. I can assure you, by the end of tomorrow, we'll have it figured out and have a good finish.
All right, buddy. Blake Cook, the leaf filter gutter protection number 11. Crew chief Chris Rice. And the boys wrenching on this thing. Kind of a subpar first practice for the another number 11 team. But Blake Cook looking for more speed. And we've got Blake Brake fans rolling through here. You got to love it. That's his workout program. That's the workout program to lift brake fans. Ryan Reed's number 16. Tell you what, these boys right here had a good time last week in Victory Lane, and you saw it on NASCAR.com. We did a little video called Crew Call, where we highlighted some of the boys on the 16 team in Victory Lane at Daytona International Speedway, including right there Benny Mingo getting it done. Make sure you check out that video if you haven't already. Really cool exclusive stuff behind the scenes. Let's see, check it in, hashtag GarageCam. Are those tires outside warming up? We're having a cold snap. It must be hard to get those things to stick. Well, not a bad suggestion, but really those tires outside aren't gaining enough temperature to really stick. The air temperature out here is relatively warm. It's more the breeze that's making it kind of cool. So that's really not going to get those things to gum up. The best thing to get those things to gum up is go out there on the track, and here's the deal why. Because this track, unlike others, this track is not smooth like this surface right here. The aggregate in this track and the stones kind of stick up through it, and this track is like a coarse sandpaper compared to maybe a loose leaf paper. It grinds these tires, and when it does that, when these tires roll over it and slide across it, it really warms them up a lot. And here's the key to the success, to find speed for the number 11 car. It's chunky peanut butter.
Natural peanut butter, that is.
Natural, so.
We need some speed for the 11 car pretty bad.
Would that get the tires to stick, chunky peanut butter?
We'll get my belly to stick. You know, I've been on this big weight loss, so I had to get me some natural peanut butter with very low sugar in it because.
I've been on a diet.
Dying to eat it?
Seafood diet.
Seafood, you eat it. So.
Yeah.
How about our new package for our XFINITY cars?
What do you think different? So far as a crew chief?
I don't know. They're throwing us for a loop right now. We're in trouble. We got to go back to the drawing board and do a little bit on our leaf filter Chevrolet. But the problem is we don't have no time. So we'll work on it. We'll race this weekend and take some notes and go to Vegas and be better. I promise you.
Well, that's a good thing, too. I'm totally different racetracks. You know, racing surface especially, but and banking and everything. But it still is a mile and a half, so there are some notes that could probably translate to that.
Absolutely. And, you know, with the new package that, you know, we hadn't talked much about, but the four-inch splitter, we have low downforce, got a brand-new tire that we hadn't run in a long time. So I'm telling you, it's kind of threw us for a little loop. But you know what, Blake, everybody on the college racing team is doing a good job. So we'll take our notes, and we'll see what it gives us tomorrow. Keep this thing in one piece so we can get better the next mile and a half. How about that?
Hey, that's what you got to do. Always keep on proving. And I don't like peanut butter.
No, natural low-sugar peanut butter.
I don't eat peanut butter. I'm un-American. Although I did have a piece of apple pie before the show. Boom, son. Hey, look. Hey, this guy right here won some kind of big race somewhere in, like, Florida or something last week.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah? Yeah, your mom always told you not to chew with your talk with your mouth full, but, you know.
I know, man. I'm trying to eat some grapes before I get in the car.
Oh, so not peanut butter like Chris Rice.
Grapes.
So is grapes the ticket, man?
I love grapes, man. All right, favorite. Give me some sugar before I get in the race car. Get my blood sugar up a little bit. Give me some energy. So I love grapes.
So how's the week been, man? I mean, obviously, it goes without saying it's been awesome, but what's the most fun, cool thing been since the second big win there at Daytona?
Honestly, I think we had this huge lunch at the shop on, I think, Tuesday or Wednesday. And we had all the guys sit around for me, the whole shop, eat lunch together. I had so much fun with those guys hanging out and BSing and just having some fun. So it's been a really good week. And honestly, it's been pretty low key. I've just enjoyed spending time with the guys and celebrating.
All right, man. Go enjoy that grape. Ryan Reed, after his big Daytona win, pretty good in practice so far for the number six car of Bubba Wallace. Not so much for Brennan Jones, the number 33 Engels car. Anderson maple syrup on it. This is a backup car because the primary car got wrecked, ran over a little bit of something on the track, caused a flat tire, a blowout, and into the wall the number 33 went, but his teammate over here, the 62 of Brennan Gaughan, hoping to pick up the slack maybe in practice for RCR. But I'll tell you what, they've got one of those RCR cars that's on the top of the board. We'll get to that car here shortly. Brennan Poole, the number 48 DC Solar entry. William Byron, strong run at Daytona, debut in the Liberty University Chevrolet. Tie-dye Ty Dillon with the camo paint scheme working here in the garage area. Number 3, Tracker Boats. Denny Hamlin in the number 20 car this weekend. One of the cuppers invading the NASCAR Xfinity Series. Kyle Larson's number 42. And here's the guy that led the first practice. The leader in first practice, the number 21 car. Oh, second? All right, Hemrick, pretty good darn first practice there. What are you guys working on to pick up here in the second?
Just trying to work on race run stuff. Qualifying's all fine and good, but can't make the thing get through the center and off the corner. It's going to be for a long day. So we'll keep working on this Blue Gate Bank Chevrolet. It's cool to be here with these guys. I promise you, no matter what, they're working hard. So it's cool to be here, man.
Hey, we've been seeing some signs around the garage area. About the Falcons, I guess, we're in Atlanta. They blew a big lead, didn't they?
That's what I heard.
Yeah, that's what I heard.
Can you believe that?
Yeah, have you seen those signs around?
I saw them everywhere.
Yeah, they're everywhere. All right, Daniel Hemrick, that's awesome right there. There was a sign on his car. That's unbelievable. They're just popping up everywhere. Unreal. Unreal. Justin Allgaier, the number 7. Right alongside Kyle Rowdy Bush, last year's winner of this Xfinity Series race. Brad Keselowski and Elliott Sather up front as well. Elliott Sather floating the real cool Hunts Brothers paint scheme. We'll show you that real quick. There it is, the number 1 of Elliott Sather for all you East Sather fans. Superstar John Lanham here talking with Justin Allgaier, getting ready for the next practice. And man, you're going to kickstart it right, aren't you?
Yeah, we are. you know, it's practice here is challenging because tire strategy, the amount of fall these tires have.
New tire.
It's hard to tell where you're at. You know, looking at the leaderboard is great, but it'll probably make you really mad when you're all said and done because you don't really have a good judge of where everything's at. But our Brent Professional Agriculture Chevy drives really well. It's just looking for that little bit of speed that we're trying to find and making sure that, you know, tomorrow in a race there's going to be at least one run where you're on tires longer than you want to be.
And your tongue's hanging out.
Oh, yeah, you're just going to be miserable. So making sure that it drives good for, you know, at least a run and a half is going to be a big deal.
And prayers, of course, for your brother Kelly there in the hospital, but I heard things are going a little bit better for
him. Yeah, things are going a lot better. So the folks who follow along on our social media, they've seen that my crew chief on my dirt car, Kelly Kowski, was hit by a sprint car that went out of Volusia. And his wife, Mandy, and his dad, Roy, and his mom, Sandy, have all been up at the hospital. They've been hanging out with him. And, you know, it's challenging to not be there. You know, we were up there every day for the first week or so, and it makes it tough to not be there. But, you know, Mandy's been keeping us updated and making sure that we know what's going on. And last night was tough, but it's going in the right direction, and today it's been really good so far. So prayers are still being, we send all the prayers we can get, but it's definitely been going in the right direction as of the last few days, so that's good.
He's got a lot to race for, Justin Allgaier, for sure. A lot of inspiration. A lot of race car drivers don't need much extra inspiration. They're a different breed, but when somebody in the fraternity is in need of prayer, might give you a little extra inspiration to try to knock out a big W. Oh, Xfinity Series practice is about to get underway. Story of the day so far has been this blue number 21, the Blue Gate Bank entry of Kannapolis, North Carolina's Daniel Hemrick. Car is about to roll out here onto the track for practice session number 2. Elliott Sather, the Hunt Brothers pizza rod. You see the number 19 of Matt Tiff rolling out, but Sather about to get into this Hunt Brothers pizza. Number 1 for practice session 2 here at Atlanta Motor Speedway. And that about does it for the show. I think we're wrapped up, right, East? That's about it. Well, as Matt Tift gets on board, this National Brain Tumor Society Toyota will remind you to tune in to the Rinnai Tankless Water Heaters 250 Saturday, part of the big doubleheader here, 2:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Make sure to tune in every week to NASCAR.com GarageCam. And until next time, we'll see you at the races.